Hello everybody. So today we are going to make chocolate chip cookies with creaming method. The ingredients which we are going to use for chocolate chip cookies are margarine. Instead of margarine, we can also use butter, powdered sugar, refined flour, chocolate chips, one egg, baking powder. Now here the baking powder, I am going to put 1/4 teaspoon of my baking powder. Here is the flour. This is how we always do. Okay, and don't forget to mix this part. And you have to make sure that you sieve it also after you put the baking powder inside. Okay, once this is mixed, and then melted fat along with the brush to grease the ring. The equipment which I use for making is a cookie tray, spatula, measuring spoons, egg beater, wooden spoon, measuring jug, there are markings over here, and a bowl, glass bowl, because I want you to see what exactly is happening over here, but I hope you can also use a steel bowl also, and a duster so that this gives a grip to the bowl. So guys, before you start creaming, make sure everything is ready over here. So as you can see, my ingredients are ready, my equipment is ready. And one more thing which is necessary is I am going to grease the tray, because this tray is going to, I am going to require it later, okay, once the cookie dough is done, so I can directly place on it. Don't apply too much of fat also, just a small, very lightly you have to grease the tray. Okay, so this is done, this is not required now because our work is done. Now what you do is, after this, just take the margarine, place here, soften this, okay, and you start creaming this. This is almost the same method which we had used for your vanilla cupcakes, okay. So once this is softened up, I am going to put the powder sugar here. I'm going to put the powder sugar part by part. I am not going to put the powder sugar all together. I'll just start creaming. Okay. I'm going to put the powder sugar part by part, as in 2-3 parts I'm going to put it inside it. Okay. And I'm going to continue creaming this. So guys, we had talked about this in vanilla cupcake also. First, you will initially check, okay, if it is too grainy. Now, I have been creaming, I had cut the video in between because otherwise the length becomes too much, okay. So, and I had already put one part of sugar here and I was continuously creaming for next 5 minutes, okay. That part of 5 minutes I have cut, okay. But now, I am going to put my second part of sugar. As I told you, we check in the initial stage, is grainy. Once the sugar starts getting mixed inside it, the graininess reduces. So that is when you come to know that you put the second part of your sugar inside. So this is, I am putting my second part of sugar here. Okay. And I am going to continue creaming. Every time just make sure that you put all the scrape everything which is there on the sides and put it in between here, and you continue creaming. Now the next part of sugar goes inside the last part, okay. sure everything is brought in the center and just wrap and continue creaming it. So guys, as I have told you before also, how do you find out whether it is done? This becomes light and fluffy, okay? You can feel less pressure on your hand and then you can touch this, feel it. The sugar granules will be, less, no? Not dissolve completely, but you will feel the granules less. So this is how my creaming is done. The side, what I do is I'm going to beat this egg, break the egg here, and you start beating. Okay? Now I'm going to put only half number of egg inside. So after beating, whatever exact half I'm going to put inside. Vanilla essence will go inside here. Never put the essence in the initial stage, always put the essence in the later stage. Nicely beat this. This is nicely beaten. Okay. Now I am going to put the flour inside. You remember I had put the baking powder inside the flour. Now just going to always remember to sieve the flour before you use it. Whenever you are putting any baking powder or any baking soda inside it, so just sieve this. Okay. Because there are chances that the baking powder will have lumps, and that one part will have only baking powder, and there are chances that that will become bitter. Okay, so just to make sure that. So the flour is sieved, and we had talked about this in vanilla cupcake also, that before putting the egg inside in this cream mixture, I am going to put some amount of flour over here. Flour goes here and I am going to mix this. Keep mixing this, make sure you scrape everything and put this in the center. Once this is mixed, I am going to put the egg. Whenever you are putting egg inside it, make sure you beat it nicely again and then you put it, because if you can see, there is liquid here and there is froth over here. So when you beat the egg and keep it for some time, it happens that the liquid starts settling in the base. We don't want that to happen. So I am just going to mix this nicely. Egg which you are putting inside also has to go part by part inside it. Okay. Just mix this nicely. Don't put all the egg together, just part by part. Every time you put the egg inside it, just make sure you beat it. Now we are trying to create an emulsion over here. Okay, we are trying to mix the fat and the egg in together. So this is going to create a slight problem while mixing. But once you keep mixing, it will get mixed properly. Can you see this will mix properly? And then just make sure remove everything from the seed. Can there is little margarine on your wooden spoon also. So just make sure you remove everything. As we had discussed before also, I have put only half egg inside it, half I have kept aside. Okay, now I am going to, once your egg mixing is done, I am going to scrape all the wooden spoon, remove everything that is there, extra mixture, and put it aside. And I am going to put all the flour together here. Okay. And you start cut and fold over here. Don't over mix this, because if you over mix this, it is going to be very soft. The cookie dough is going to be very soft, and then it will be very difficult for you to handle it. Okay. Now, when you are putting the egg also, just make sure that you put only half egg inside it. Don't put a little more than half, nor you put little less than half. If you put little more than half, the dough is going to become very soft, and if you put in less, it is going to become hard. So the texture will affect in that case. Okay. So can you see now? Okay? Just cut and fold this nicely. Once this is done, what you do is just take this and you can place it here. Mix this. Don't over mix this, because we don't want the gluten to be formed over here. Okay, so just take a scraper, take little extra flour. This flour is not from the recipe, this extra flour which you're using for dusting. Place it here. I am going to roll this. Now when I am rolling, if you see, I am rolling it like this. Okay, the flour is covering. If it starts sticking over here, you will immediately put little more flour over there and you will roll it. Okay, try to make a cylinder here like this. Okay, now what I am going to do is, now understand the temperature, chocolate is, if you hold it in your hand, it is going to become, it is going to start melting. So you don't have to touch it too much and not handle it too much also. Very lightly just put this chocolate chip here like this. Hold it like this here. Okay, this is one side I had folded. Now what I do is, so all the sides basically my chocolate chip has gone. Apply too much pressure on this, and don't make it a very big long cylinder also, and this has to be an even this thing. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to cut this, okay, and I am going to divide this into 20 portions. So when I am cutting, first half of this two, half here. Okay, the same way what we did for the bread rolls. So from your 5, 5, 5 and 5 from your 1 approximately I'll remove, and then half, half, half. Okay, same thing I'll do here. 1 approximately, half and half. 1 approximately, half and half. So cut this like this. If you think any piece is little small or big, you can do the adjustment. Now what you do, I have already divided this, just start rolling this, okay? Try to make a circle like this. Okay, so when you are rolling now, I have already rolled all of this. Just make sure don't roll it too much. Because first thing is that the chocolate, because of your heat, body temperature, it is going to start melting. And second thing is, if you keep on rolling this, it is going to start sticking. Plus, this is going, the chocolate chips will go inside. So we don't want the chocolate chips to go inside it. They have to be on the top so it looks, it is visible basically, okay? Now, what I'm just going to place it here. Arrange this like this. They are on equal distance here, like this. Okay. Now just check. In this case, normally what they do is they flatten the cookie. But in this case, the flattening is not required because this already has fat inside it. Margarine basically, or fat inside it. So that will help it to melt and give that shape to the cookie. Now you will check. Now for example, I can see that there is, this one is small and this one is a little big, so I can always remove this little bit and place this here, and this can go here. So like this you have to do the adjustment just in case required. Now this one is a little big. Almost all of them are done now. Okay. And now this will go for baking. Now we have to bake this piece at 150